Hi, everyone. I was just doing the hustle. Like, what an amazing song. Awesome. All right. I think we're good to go here. All right. I'm going to go ahead and share the slides to keep me on track. But welcome, welcome to the Mom Coach Side Hustle Masterclass. So let me just get my slides ready for you. Do, 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 do. And I believe we are on this page. No, we're not. Give me 2 seconds left. I'm hustling here to get the slides going on. Oh my goodness. All right. Let me just take a quick boop. And one final try here. I am going to pull up. I think I see where I'm at. Share this screen. Oh. 2 seconds, my loves. I think here we are. Okay, here we go. Shannon, are we tickety boo here?
Don't see them yet.
Okay, here we go. I think let me know if you see my slide. It might take a second.
Yeah, I can see them.
Yeah, but it looks like a couple people. Okay, some are still connecting to audio as well.
Okay. All right. So welcome. Slides are seen. Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Okay. Welcome, everyone. So I'm just going to make sure everyone's on mute. I am also going to get the views all set up here. Thanks for your patience, loves. Okay. We got views going on. Do the hustle. Just love that song. And you're welcome if you get that stuck in your head for the rest of the day. Okay, here we go. So I have my assistant Shannon here helping me out, admitting people and facilitating the chats. So Shannon, is everything tickety-boo? You can see the slides and you can hear me okay?
Yep, everything looks perfect.
Awesome. Wonderful, hen. Okay. Welcome. Welcome. We're going to dive right in. This is the masterclass for you. And I just want for you to just take it all in, being super present and available for all the teachings that are coming your way. So let's keep the distractions at a minimum. So if you can think of it, actually, I'm glad I had that slide because it's reminding me to put my silence on my own phone off. And yeah, just enjoy this gift to dive into this daydream or real dream you got going on here of running a blissful mom coaching biz. So as a thank you for showing up live, I want you to stay until the end because I created this weekend. I did the video yesterday and it was very poignant because it was for Mother's Day and I just blew myself away. I was quite pleased. It's all about self-care for mom coaches. And I just had this amazing epiphany lately that I cannot wait to share with you in this free training. So you really want to get your paws on this because it's not offered anywhere else. And if I do say so myself, it's pretty genius. So this is going to help you regardless if you're just starting out, if you're already out there coaching, this is going to give you a beautiful, blissful edge. And speaking of workbooks, there's also the workbook for the training. And I think Shannon's going to put a link for that for you below too, if you hadn't had a chance to nab it. But otherwise, let's dive in. In case you don't know me, I'm Kathy. I am the biz coach for moms who coach moms and the founder of Bliss Beyond Nap Time. Before I did all things bliss, I was in sales and marketing straight out of university. I did 5 years doing marketing and sales for medical professionals. And I'm smiling because I am easily heebie-jeebied. I was working on doing marketing for hair transplanters, LASIK eye surgeons, and I worked for FWJ, which was a huge advertising firm back in the day. And I did that for 5 years before we moved out to the middle of nowhere. And I was awakened with the entrepreneurial spirit, something I was born and raised into. I've come from a family of entrepreneurs. And when my husband and I moved to the country, I was craving community, first of all. And I was feeling a little isolated. We had a hobby farm way out in the deep woods. And I found community when I started blogging as a way to document our adventure in hobby farming. And I was hyper crafty, and it was just a really fun way to meet other moms who shared similar interests as me. And when my son was born, I started daydreaming, like, what can this look like? Me melding this newfound passion for blogging at the time, which led to connecting with these moms. And I was selling stuff online, Etsy shopping, and creating a whole bunch of things. But what this led me to was working with moms because they were asking, how is it that you are having so much fun being hyper crafty, farming, doing all the things, and still looking pretty energetic for the most part? So I decided I wanted to coach moms because I saw in their eyes how it lit up when I started offering online sewing courses. And I realized it went deeper than learning how to use a sewing machine. It was deeper. It was more like protecting that time to tap into your passions outside motherhood, to connect with community of other moms to support each other. So I did a lot of research and sleuthing and thinking and talking to people, working with a career coach, and I landed on becoming a mom coach. Since becoming a mom coach, my clients were often like, once we found that quiet center, when they prioritized their self-care and they had more creative fun beside their children and getting really clear on what their values are leading them to and simplifying their days around that, they started telling me, like a huge percentage of them, I want to do what you do. I want to support moms in this capacity. And so since then, I started training moms to coach moms. I started business coaching to help them lean and home in on what their little special sauce is. And I have helped over 100 moms, like way over 100, either start their biz or grow their biz. And I've been doing this since 2012. So over a decade. And I know this inside out, backwards, forward, and inside outside hustle. So other than that, real quick, fun tidbits. Married to my husband now for 20 years, almost 21, actually next month. We have two adorable teens, and they are now, if you can believe it, 18 and 14. And I have so many of my followers who've been following me since my blog was called Love Tangerine Dreams, and that's my daughter's middle name. And their minds are blown when they learn that she's graduating from high school this year. And I had two wiener dogs, Angel and Wilbur, and they are my shadow. They're like, everyone in the family's like, mama loves the dogs best. So big fan of the dogs. And lately I discovered my purpose in life outside of coaching moms, and that is pickleball. Any chance I get, I'm out there on the courts kicking Mavis and Eleanor's ass. I'm just kidding. They kick my ass. Anyways, I love it more than words could say. So that's what my bliss is all about these days. And if you want to follow my bliss and mostly about my coaching business and get inspired by that stuff, I'm on Instagram. That's a newfound bliss for me, actually. Just in the last year, I've really been getting into it. So check me out at Blissed, past tense, Beyond Nap Time over on Instagram. All right. So you're in the right place. If you're still deciding, you're getting exhausted by the flip-flopping. Ooh, I want to coach moms. Ugh, no, I don't have the time. Or, ooh, I really want to do this. Or no, like, who am I? So you just have all that flip-flopping, which is exhausting when it comes sometimes to the decision-making process. Or if you know for certain you do want to do this and you just aren't sure now, what's holding you back is the time constraints. Like, how can I make this work with the limited time that I do have? And maybe you're already in what I kind of consider my favorite part of any creative or life project is that research part. That could be fun, but it also could be a little time sucky. So you're just like, I know I want to go on this path. I just want to know what's the most direct way to do this. And you want to see if this is even possible in a way that isn't going to see you just super burnt out or just getting really deflated by the process and just wanting to give up before things actually start rocking and rolling. Okay, so I've actually was there too. So again, when I was doing the Etsy shop thing, I had an Etsy shop for art yarn I made. I would go to the local farms and get fiber and clean it and spin it and add dingly doodads and like literal tinkle bells. I would put all this wacky stuff in the yarn and then I would sell it. And I incorporated into my blogging. It was really, really fun, but exhausting. It was fun, but exhausting. Even though I got energized making it, it just was like, oh, going to the post office. And I also was making clothes. I had another Etsy shop where I made clothes and I had all my kids' babysitters model them. I would sell it. It just felt like I was always at the post office. I was up really late, like making this stuff. And then it just felt kind of sad to like send it off. So I knew though that I was on the trajectory of finding something. It was just like putting my finger, like I knew that there was some bliss in that, the creative aspect, but it wasn't quite it. And on top of all that, as you see me in the photo here, I'm kissing our little miniature cow, Miss Daisy. We had a milk cow for 5 years and we were like we were very tight. You know, when you have to milk someone every day, you get pretty close. So it wasn't sustainable. So I was busy. So like I said, I was still meditating, working with coaches even to help me narrow down what are my options here. So this is what I decided that worked. So one of the prompts from one of the career coaches I worked with was, what is it that your followers or people ask you over and over again? And as I touched on, they were asking, well, how is it that you do all that you do? And it came back to honoring principles of simplicity and making sure that I prioritize creative play. This goes back to actual health stuff from homework from an acupuncture that I worked with. Even before I had kids, I wanted to get hyper healthy, both physically, but also emotionally before I had kids. And one of my assignments was to open up my throat chakra. In other words, express myself. And I noticed with having kids in the picture now that if we simplified our days, I had time to prioritize that self-care, that nurturing of my throat chakra, expressing myself in fun ways. And I picked up that my energy got buoyed. So I decided that if I apply these principles to my entrepreneurial pursuits, then it will offer the same results, which is everything just streamlines together and it doesn't feel like work and it happens in less time. It's snappier, it's funner, and you can just be led by what I call the bliss crumbs, like whatever feels good and keep it simple. So when I applied this to my coaching business, I first decided to go with the training first of becoming a simplicity parenting coach. Cause again, I was like, yeah, simplicity is where it's at. And also I became a certified creativity coach through Kaizen Muse. And it was, yeah, the same points of resistance and blocks that moms experience is the same that creatives experience. Melding them together, I came up with the foundation of my coaching training and my coaching approach, but I apply everything that works there also onto my business. And it turns out I have in the last decade purely been only working when the kids are at school. And my kids go to a private school here and it feels like they're never at school because it always feels like it's a holiday. So I think it evens out that it's part-time hours and I am making way beyond what I was making full-time working at these advertising and marketing agencies. Okay, so how about we do the same for you? If I had the technology, we would have the side hustle theme song going on here. Just imagine. Let's go. Okay, so we're going to begin with allowing your mind to relax into what is actually possible here. So the thing is, a lot of one tool I use a lot in my trainings and with my clients is what I call the BHG. So if you've been following me for a while, you know that stands for brain, heart, and gut. We always start with the brain just to calm the nervous system. Let's look at the facts here. And then we get ourselves grounded by moving that down to the heart of like, what is my heart moved by emotionally? And then down to our gut, just trusting our inner gut knowing. So let's begin with the brain. And these are the facts. Why now is perfect time to start a side hustle as a mom coach. If you're just like trickling in, we are going to save some time at the end for questions. So just tap them into the chat box and Shannon's going to read them to me at the very end. And stay until the end. Again, if you just came in, there's a sweet little treat for all that stick around. I got hooked on this new latte called Latte con Miel. Little honey, little cinnamon, and it's just taking my bliss to a whole other level. Okay, so now's the perfect time to start a side hustle. There is increased demand. So what I mean by increased demand, it is a marriage of, pandemic. Everyone obviously was really a little more stressed out than normal, right? You know, change is hard. So that was a big wacky change. First of all, so increased demand, it really brought to everyone's surface of like, whoa, yeah, there's a lot of unknowns out there. So just people were more open, first of all, to finding the help and support they needed with the stressors, right? But what I'm talking about here, it's more the technical stuff. People were like, whoa, it's almost possible to do anything remotely. During the pandemic, I'm trying to do the math here. Yeah, it was during the pandemic. Like I was even able to do like a photo shoot virtually, like have a photographer do like my branding photos for like my business. So it just, I think it really made people aware of Zoom existed. Like a lot of people didn't even know what Zoom was just 3 years ago. So people are more comfortable with that techie aspect. And so they're more open-minded to working with a coach who may live like literally on the other side of the world. I've had clients literally on the other side of the world. So the demand is there, the awareness that coaching exists. And, you know, people living all over. Oh, here, we're going to get to that in point three. But basically, there are more clients out there who are open to getting coach and know that coaching is a thing. It's not as weird as it used to be. Now's a perfect time because low overhead. All you need really is a laptop and internet connection and everything else. You can get really creative, okay? So as you get your business bigger, as it grows, then you can start investing into more bells and whistles. And that is a term I use a lot with my own business coaching is keep it simple, keep it simple. And then when you have more time and resources, then you can start getting a little more high tech. But for now, it's so simple now to begin. Even if you want to start with a podcast, you can do that with your phone. Again, this touches upon the technology aspect, but it's just so much easier. It's just easier and easier, user-friendly ways to get started. Niches just got broad. And that's not meant to be a pun, working with moms. So again, thank you, internet. It's like, how lucky are we to be born in this time where this is even possible? So I'm just thinking like my mom was self-employed as well. She worked from home as a seamstress. And that was like old, old school. I'm not going to say how old, but she was pretty old school, right? So we get to do this from home. And the beauty of it is one thing that's close to my heart in terms of coaching success is really home in on a niche statement. Even if your niche is mom coach, we're going to finagle that a bit so it's more specific, at least for season. So we'll get into that in a second. But no matter how narrow you get, again, technology, we could throw out our message out to the world and it can come back with your ideal client. We can just trust they will find you. Just be a beacon. And then the creative renaissance, the technology, this again has been the underlying theme on everything of why now is perfect. It's with less time as a side hustle, you can like do things so much faster. Again, the phone. I just got this new phone and the video it takes, it's like, whoa, it's like people think I have like a professional videographer. It's like the quality is so good. There's templates out for social media posts, reels. Like it's so fun. It's not just simple, but again, like I was saying how I noticed, like when I started my Etsy shops, the creative part kind of got me like excited in the morning. Like even though long-term it wasn't sustainable because physically I was up late and, you know, I had to do all that stuff. And the return on my time, dollars per hour wasn't very lucrative. There's still that fun factor here. You can get creative and technology has made it like this creative release that this, there's so much, there's this great book called Steal Like an Artist. It's see how we can interpret things into our own flavor. And even AI, I wrote this here. I'm not saying that. And actually, I just read an article yesterday. I clicked on it because, again, my daughter, she's going to university pretty quick, finishing high school. And that's been in the back of my mind because her passion is writing. She's a really gifted writer. And I'm just like, oh man, how is AI going to affect some of these careers? This article I found yesterday, I read just because I was kind of like curious. And it said one of the careers that cannot be replaced by AI is coaching, because there is that human factor there that can't be replaced. But it's a great tool when we feel stuck, even just to get our idea wagon rolling. There's so many creative ways we can lean on technology just to kind of get the ball rolling. And then we could, use our own certain je ne sais quoi into what is our take on this, so we can still show up as the authentic, gorgeous human being that we are. Okay. So again, finding your secret sauce. If you're like, I don't have je ne sais quoi, je pense to have it. I used to speak fluent French when I was a kid growing up in Montreal, and it's, oh God. So anyways, you do have it. You have it. Imagine me saying that to you in French. So how to find it? There's so many ways to find it. One way is to, again, piece of paper, do a biography, break up your existence into 7-year chunks. So just write down from ages 0 to 7, what happened in your life. So you can just write down like really interesting things that happen, if you feel ready to, like, you know, some struggles you've overcome, experiences that you feel proud of, and what your interests were, right? I remember little Kathy Sita as a kid. My parents would bring their buddies over for dinner, and I would put on a play, and I would make all the kids in the house. I would be the director, the star, the writer, the screenwriter. So what were you into as a munchkin? How can that, you know, remind you of what is it that brings you alive? And then do the same thing for the next 7 years. So from 7 to 14, what were you into? Your extracurricular activities, your first job. 14 to 21, what'd you do after high school? What clubs were you part of in high school? What happened, right? And then 21 to right before you had kids. So it's a great, great way to look, again, looking at the brain. Okay, what happened? What have I experienced? And then you can also look at your energy, right? Everyone has a different sense of humor. The way you talk, the way you think, everyone has a different way to intellectualize things. How you describe, you know, your perspective on the world, your voice. And again, here, your je ne sais quoi, like you showing up as yourself. When I talk about energy, all of this, I feel like everything I'm covering since the moment I started doing the side hustle dance and to the end of this training, all of it is reminders. It is a reminder. So becoming a coach, learning what the coaching tools and using them not only on your future clients, but we're also using it on ourselves. And I always say coaching tools are just basically reminders of what we already know within, right? So why I'm bringing this up, because when I see the word energy, I think of how the last 2 years, but especially the last year and a half, I've really been going deep in human design, and I even got certified as a human design expert and using it in your coaching business. But what I love about it, I saw in my chart, I'm like, oh my gosh, I have this channel that is all about the artistic creative. And it's like, oh, it's very important for me to have some kind of creative outlet every day. So that's why I love making reels on Instagram. I love doing trainings like this, because making the slides is a fun creative outlet. You know, doing a little like side hustle dance before I teach really gets my energy up. So just remind yourself of, like, you know, what makes you, right? And also learning about my human design, I learned how important it is to share those personal stories, to share use my voice. And and also the thinking, it explained a lot on Holy, I do have opinions. I forgot I had opinions, if that sounds weird or not. So it reminded me of like, ooh, this is really who I am at the core of the center. And I can't muffle that because there are, as much as there's more demand for coaching, there's also more coaches out there, right? I'm not saying that as a scarcity thing, but we're all not showing up with this mind-blowing, unique idea. But the way we show up with that special way we are, then we are going to, it's like dating, right? That those pheromones, that chemistry is going to attract our right people. What keeps this simple is you just being your authentic self. Anything else is going to be a time waster. And we're doing this as a side hustle. We don't have time to waste. Just show up as yourself and you will rock this. Number three, a little bit more cerebral, is what are the tactical skills and experience you bring in terms of career, trainings? Because you know that you are an expert in certain areas, right? So maybe you took a course in something you're interested in, or you know, you got a degree in something. Like there's some way you could weave this into your business. And finally, your values. There's lots of values tests that you can take online. Again, whenever you're feeling indecisive, I always go to the values, right? Even when we moved from the hobby farm, my husband and I did a values test side by side, and it helped us own that it was a very emotional decision to move from that hobby farm, because that was our second date discussion, which was kind of weird. It's like, where do you want to live? I want to raise my kids with cows, right? Like, we came to that vision together, and it's like, ooh, now what are we going to do? We decided we wanted simplicity, and that's the word that came up, simplicity and sustainability. Yeah, because my husband wanted to be able to ride his bike to town. Anyways, check out your values. This is part of your secret sauce, and really see, there's place in your workbook too, to just got to remind the workbook. There is some prompts there for you to record some of this, but let's just take a look at our values. Okay. So there's space in the workbook too, where the prompt is, which of the two coaching tools I introduce you to really kind of speak and you're going to like dive into a bit deeper? Well, there's three. As I was making the slides, I'm like, actually, there's one more I wanted to share. The one that was like, ooh, this one's good, is an intake form for yourself. So you are going to be your number one client, even at this stage of you becoming a coach, the daydreaming component, just kind of thinking about it. Let's coach you, because you already have the skill sets to coach yourself. If you're thinking about coaching moms, chances are very good that you have kids. So, you know, how you comfort them, or even how you comfort yourself when you're feeling overwhelmed, the self-talk that you offer, you know, all, you know, if you're drawn to this, chances are very good that you're the friend a lot of people come to for advice. It just, there's that energy about you. Coaches come in all shapes, sizes, and flavors, but there's something about you that's coachy. So let's tap into that. So let's coach yourself here, where you're at, where we began at the very beginning, whether you're deciding, you're trying to imagine what this is going to be like, you're not sold on if you can actually make money if you're doing this part-time, or if you, you know, got small kids and you're just like, how am I going to do this? So imagine that you are literally your client, and I encourage you to try filling out a form to work with you. So when people want to work, typically with coaches, but definitely if they want to work with me, there's an intake form they take when they book a discovery call. So just for funsies, you don't have to do it with me, but check out a coach, check, just even read what their intake form asks, and do something similar for yourself. You could ask yourself, so you know, where do you see yourself? What are your goals? Where do you see yourself a few years from now? What have you tried in the past that didn't work? Why, you know, coming out of this, you know, what do you want to achieve working together? So see if you can do that for yourself. And what I did with my clients is to have them go on a Zoom call like this and actually hit record and even like read out the question and then just talk it out. One of the first coaching lessons I offer inside my coaching training program, Mom Coach School, is that being a coach is also just like being a midwife. And when we had our first visit with our midwife, with our first kiddo, she said, this is the first midwife lesson they taught us. She went to school in the UK. For some reason, I remember that. And then she proceeded to just like sit on her hands. And she said, we are taught just to hold that space and allow the birthing process to develop as it should. The mom knows what to do. We just hold space for her. So this is very similar as coaching moms. Moms know what the next step is, but there's often some fear. There's some resistance, some conditioning that's holding her back, you know, people pleasing, what have you. So what we do is, and I know it's hard for me because I'm a chatty Kathy, as you probably can tell. We must learn to bite our tongue. Sometimes mine bleeds a little bit, but this is a great opportunity to practice asking a question and then record yourself asking the question and then just talking. If you want to play coach on yourself, you can even prompt yourself to say, and what else? And what else? Just encourage you to keep talking. And then later you can either just listen to what you said, or for funsies, you can get the audio transcribed. There's so many. Again, we lived in a glorious time. The technology, I like rev.com. I don't know if it's a cool thing to do anymore, but pretty inexpensive. And I'm sure Google Doc, just transcribe what you said and just see what's come up for you. So that's a good way to see what's really under the surface of what might be holding you back. But also maybe there's some gems there. You could be like, actually, I do believe I can do this. So that's a great coaching yourself exercise. The second one I offer is called the daydream machine. And I still do this every day, not very formal meditation, which you could offer yourself. But how I do it when I wake up in the morning, I have the timer, my alarm set for 6:20. And my husband's set for 6:30. So he loves this. So my alarm goes off at 6:20. And our two wiener dogs, you know, they sleep with me side by side. And I just lie there in corpse pose and just daydream what's coming up in my day. And I get excited about it. Like today, I was like lying in bed for 10 minutes, eyes open, squishing the puppies, and like, yes, I get to do the side hustle dance. I get to show off these slides and I get to share with them what's coming up and invite them into Mom Coach School and share with them my three favorite coaching tools. So just really like being in the present moment, taking in that gratitude of what is there, but also what's just around the corner. So you can also do this for yourself when you're thinking about, you know, a year from now, what's it going to look like if I go for this? And either with a guided meditation, imagine your kids a year older. For some reason, that's very powerful. Like thinking like however old your kids are, adding 1 year to that number. Oof, that just like opens like all these different scenarios. Like maybe next year your kids are going to be in school, or like mine, one of them is going to be done school. So it's just a great way to imagine what can this look like. If we have a vision, then we have a basically a compass. Quick story. We've lived in this property now in this house. I don't know why I keep saying property, but it's, you know, Facebook told me 9 years. If feels, yeah, it's been about 9 years now. In this 8-9 years, we lived in this house. Brand new suburb. We have a blank canvas of our yard. And was it just a few days ago, I had a landscape consultant come over and she drew up, I don't have it here, it's over there, a quick little sketch of the possibilities. And I've been giddy since that day. So having that visualization of how it can be, it gets you into action. So I'm ready to go to the garden center and get me some lavender and daisies. And I am ready to call a landscaper guy to like transplant this oak tree that's planted in the wrong spot. So I'm ready to get that magnolia tree just so I could start taking baby steps. And I'm excited and pulled towards living in that reality. I am so excited for that one. So the daydream machine, you can either do it very formally with a seated guided meditation, seeing yourself living this reality, or even baby step, do it as part of your morning or going to bed ritual. And finally, my favorite coaching tool, and you can run a whole coaching session around this, is 3 quick questions. What can I celebrate here? That's a great way to put you in that energy. And okay, where are we stuck here? And again, what has worked in the past? Like I shared at the very beginning, what has worked in the past in my parenting when I got overwhelmed was to hit pause, slow things down, and simplify things. And same thing could be applied to your biz. Okay, I'm just checking the time and I'm like, oof, we got to get to part two pretty quick. So here's some mistakes that are quite common when it comes to starting a coaching biz. Mistake number one, I've had clients come to me saying, I just invested in this website design when they don't even really have a business or business vision or plan yet. So and then they often use this as an excuse to putting themselves out there. It's like, well, I don't want to like make a sales page yet, or, you know, say I have to wait until this happens. So don't get held up with those type of details. It's more important that you make it clear that you can help and you can help. And I'm going to help you learn how you can help. But tech-wise, don't get caught up in the techie aspect, because you really, again, you don't need a website. You just need a social media account that can link to your free opt-in. You do need an email service provider. I am a stickler with that. We need to build your email list and then an online scheduler. And even that is optional, but it's a nice professional touch. And number two is overthinking every little decision. And this is why I love discovering human design, because I learn the importance of you bringing my brain down to my gut more and trusting my gut instinct. So this is different for everyone, but for most people, it's think less, feel more, and take action. Or what I like to call is follow your bliss crumbs. And finally, and this is related, not having a niche statement. So when I say niche statement, it's like the I help statement, a little different from choosing a niche. If you are watching this training, celebrate, because you have a niche, right? Mom coach. You can just call yourself a mom coach. But I want you, and I say private, what I mean is in your heart, have a statement. I help moms who are struggling with this, so they can get to a result. This will make it possible for you to make $1,500 a month on part-time hours, because this is what we riff off of on the 4x1 plan. Your niche statement, your offer that coincides with that, and there's just two more things. Just show up, build that email list, send out that weekly email, show up, offer free weekly content, and you could do that on your social media. And there's another one. This gets me right now. No, I think we got it. It'll come to me in a second. There's slides. There's more slides. So all of these, like not choosing a niche, being worried about not having enough of a online sexy presence, or being worried about the tech stuff. And what was the other one? What was the other one? I'm going to go back for 2 seconds. Number two. Oh yeah. Overthinking things. just decide to be decisive. These are fear-based. Like, what if I make the wrong decision? This is perfectionism holding us back. What if it's not perfect? You're worried that you're not good enough and that you don't know what you're doing. You're not sure this is going to work. And if I go for it and it doesn't work, something really bad is going to happen. I want to assure you, you are good enough. You have the skill sets, as you explored in the section where we looked at what you bring to the table now. You just got to fill in the gaps, and that's totally possible. As long as you keep your business simple, your coaching tangible, meaning your coaching signature offer has like a practical level to it that you deliver some goods with that. And you just don't give up. Your success will be inevitable. And I wrote here, you're willing to go all in. So now's time to talk to me in the chat. Are you ready to finally start a coaching business that not only can it replace your day job salary or what you made before you had kids, if your maternity leave, but in a way that it feels like you're retired already because you're doing something that you love to do. Like when I deke off to pickleball in the middle of the day, all of my pickleballers are like, don't you have a job? Like, I do, but it's very flexible. But I think also it's like, I had this energy. It's like, I just love what I do so much. All right, we got some smiley faces. So go ahead in the chat. I'm going to close this. Okay, and also, do you see how being able to coach moms confidently can help your future coaching clients? Meaning, yeah, I have evidence that I can help because I am deciding to go all in one specific area and become an expert. This builds confidence. So I sound like a broken record. If you follow me on Instagram, you might notice I talk about all this stuff over and over again from different angles, from up here, from down there, from sideways. And as I go out and experience life, like I have so many pickleball analogies, like how pickleball is exactly like coaching, then you can bring it in. And it's like, oh, like I told you, that gift I'm about to share, this is something that just like something I've been teaching, self-care. It's actually the first section of Mom Coach School. All of a sudden, I got this really cool angle on it that comes from showing up over and over consistently and talking about one main struggle over and over and becoming the expert. And then tell me in the chat too, are you ready to learn how to coach moms and then how to get clients into this coaching package, this results focus offer that you can sell for at least $1,000. Okay, this is my angel. This is one of my puppies. Imagine waking up each morning to this little face and or your dog or your partners, knowing you get to do what your soul is craving, coaching moms. So an extra $1,500 a month during part-time hours, how will that impact you and your family's lives, right? And having the opportunity, and this one really gets me a little weepy, it's like our kids are watching. Like my daughter, again, she grew up watching me do this. She is my biggest cheerleader. When I've had like a huge success in my business, her bedroom's conveniently located just around the corner. I go in there and I do like the hustle, but she's so cute. She's like, great. You know, like she gets it and she sees me doing what I love. So I know, and I trust, like I'm showing her it is possible to find work that it's like winning the life lottery. Okay. So you have two choices. You can take what I taught here today and try to figure it out on your own, or let me help you. Let me help you help others. Let me teach you how to coach moms, and then you can ease into the business part of it, whenever works for you. And you'll see, like my business, I started this when Kale was a baby. He's 14 now. And my business has grown as the kiddos has grown. Okay, so here we go. So Mom Coach School is how I can help you. This is what I wish was available when I was doing that research and development, when I knew I wanted to work with, already I had in my heart, my ideal clients. There were these mamas who were taking my sewing class. And when they sent me pictures with their little outfits they sewed, thinking they didn't have enough time to like pursue a passion of theirs, this is what pulled me. I wish there was a program for moms to coach moms in this really sacred way. And this is what Mom Coach School is all about. And it's 3 months of a weekly lesson teaching you how to coach yourself and then coach moms coming into your inbox, and includes a video, no more than 20 minutes. Maybe some of them are 23, some of them are a bit shorter, of me talking like this, walking you through that lesson. And then for a whole year, you're invited to our weekly Q&A calls with other mom becoming coaches or who are already coaching, asking me questions about the curriculum or how to get clients. There's also a private Facebook group we convene at, and you also get lifetime access to Mom Coach Club. Lots of resources in there to help you. So this is created by a mom for moms to learn how to coach moms confidently. And again, I curated and came up with the tools and approaches that moms respond beautifully to. They have a very non-linear approach. They're very non-authoritative. It's just very creative. Again, creative tools. And my whole premise too, the Kaizen use aspect, is taking that big vision of what life can look like and then breaking it down into small doable steps. So you get to learn at your own pace. So the minute you join, you get sent out your first lesson. And then once a week, next week, you'll get the next lesson and you're immediately invited into those weekly calls. But there's no pressure, take it as you go. So the lessons are there for you forever. And again, I'm all about keep overwhelm at bay. So the lessons are bite-sized and emphasis on simplicity. And you also get a accountability buddy or a practice buddy. This is optional, but in module 2, you get introduced to the framework of how to coach. And that's when you could apply to get your buddy assigned to you. So module 1, each module is 4 lessons. So for the first month, you get to experience the tools and the approach on yourself. Very similar how we did with the intake form. But each week you get a lesson. The first one, again, it's on self-care. Next week would be about creativity, your values and simplicity. So you get to experience the tools by moving through the video lesson and the workbook, and you get to be like, ooh, I like that one. Whatever you like, chances are very good your future clients are going to love it too. Whatever you like about coaching, this is who you're going to attract. And you're also going to learn about the mindset needed. So mindset's going to ebb and flow. So we're going to learn how to bring it back, because guarantee you're going to have days where, ooh, those feelings are coming up. You're like, ooh, is this too much success? I better like bring that down a notch. So we're going to explore this and learn it's safe to feel all the feelings and to keep showing up anyway. Okay. Module 2, that's when you get formally introduced to the framework, the coaching tools. And I like to say this is like training wheels, that just follow the framework. It's going to show you what to do when through a hypothetical 4 coaching session package. So you can experience like, oh, okay, this is a good time to pull into my coaching toolkit, pull this one out. And this is how I introduce it to my client. And then finally you could take those wheels off and make your coaching practice a reflection of what you're all about and what works for you and you witness in your clients. Again, you meet your assigned practice buddy. And if you go for this option, you agree to meet with her for at least 4 weekly sessions. And oh, the friendships that happen here, honestly, like a long time. I've been offering this training for years, and I see that these friendships have endured. This is very potent stepping stone here. And you also learn how to bring your coaching skills out into your on or offline community and support them, and also gain awareness and really own your persona and as a mom coach. And finally, this leads us to selling your coaching services. You're going to find your niche. I'm going to help you come to your niche and come up with a low-tech organic sales funnel, or as I like to call it, your sales uterus. And I'm all about the 4x1, which is designed as the bare minimum to show up. But because we come up with a very clear niche and coaching package, you just need to show up really quick every day, but consistently. And the very last lesson is all about mastering work-life bliss balance. I know it's controversial, but I'm going to share with you what my take is on the whole debate and why it is doable, possible, and it'll help you avoid burnout so you don't give up. So we're going to get into testimonials here, but Shannon, I think too might be a good time to release the gift, I think. I can't remember if there's slides coming up, but actually, we'll see. Pretty quick, it'll be released. I can't remember the slides, if I have a slide for the gift or not. Right. So maybe I'll talk about the gift in a sec, but first, this is my client, Jessica. She's gone through mom coach school just very recently. She went through the winter cohort. I'm going to really quickly read what she shared. She wanted a program that would zero in on the ways to work specifically with moms and their struggles. And the format for mom coach school worked well for her. The lessons provided each week made it less overwhelming and to add it to her schedule. And it was motivational to complete it each week. And now she has a 12-week coaching package to take moms from overwhelm and loneliness to empowered and excited to make connections and build friendships. I love that niche so much because I can totally relate. Mom Coach School is well worth the investment of your time and money. I'm walking away with a clear plan for my coaching process, a toolbox full of tools, and an expert I can send questions to weekly as I move forward in my business. Kathy has great energy. And I've learned a lot from the content she provided. Thanks, Kathy. And that's Jessica. And here we go, Danielle. She shares she was a stay-at-home mom. Again, like me, she had an Etsy shop and she wanted to work with healing and empowering moms. And now she has the confidence and courage to move forward to add coaching to her offerings. And she knows it's going to make a difference for her future clients. She says, I'm fun and interesting. Oh, take on coaching. That makes it really easy to stay motivated. She's a wealth of information and not shy about sharing it. That's it, you guys. In case you can't tell, I wear my heart on my sleeves and I will do anything to help you see you succeed. And she definitely recommends to anyone looking to get into coaching. Danielle, she is rocking it. She's gone through the program last year now, the former rendition of it, but it was exactly what she was looking for. She went from zero to starting her coaching business. Perfect for someone just like me 3 months ago, very newbie. I learned the tools and coaching process and this whole experience has been very comfortable and she feels like she really lucked out finding the program. Okay, so here is the early bird bonus that's available until Tuesday at midnight. I'm talking tomorrow. I'm talking May 13th at midnight. This is a steal of a deal. I was telling Shannon earlier, I'm like, this is crazy. But so there's two tiers to Mom Coach School, 997 or VIP, which is 1997. I am offering VIP at 997 only. So you get coaching training plus 3 one-on-one sessions for me to be used up in the first 3 months. So once a month, we'll come together and basically customize what you are learning to what you are envisioning in terms of who you want to work with and how, et cetera. and 3 months Voxer support. If you don't know what Voxer is, it's like a walkie-talkie on your phone. If you get stuck, you just doot-doot and leave me a voice message. And during my work hours, I'll respond as quickly as I can. So be basically like having me in your back pocket. And if you do this, if you sign up while this call is still happening, you'll also get a bonus of a 90-minute human design reading with me. Shannon, can we do the hustle theme music again? I'm just kidding. It's not possible. Yeah. So now I'm being silly. I think that one meal is hitting me now. But so that means for $997, you get coaching training. You get me in your back pocket for 3 months. You get 3 one-on-one sessions with me, plus human design for your mom coaching biz reading. We'll show you what your purpose is, how you make the best decisions, what your superpowers are, how you should be marketing your business, what your x-ray vision is as a coach. Like really, you guys, I learned about human design and my mind just went, I'm like, I must learn more. And I am obsessed now. So 997, and you get all of this. Again, the human design bonus is just if you sign up before the end of this call, but the VIP at regular price is available until tomorrow at midnight. But why not just do it now? Why not? So I know when people say total value, it just sometimes feels like, well, this is an arbitrary number, but I want to assure you, like really, you guys, coaching training programs, there's one, I'm not going to name names, but I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. Last I heard, Shannon, I don't know if you know what I'm talking about, but it's at least like 20 grand. Hey, like it used to be 17 and then it went up to 20. Okay. Like I'm not that. By any measure, but I'm offering here, it's at least like a lot, right? So, but if you include working with me privately for 5 months, for 6 months is 5,000 right then and there. That's how my private clients work with me. My human design readings, between $200, $300, it depends. You get lifetime access to Mom Coach Club. You get a BFF forever. You get a lot. Year access. So like a mastermind almost. So easily $10,000 for $1,000 essentially. Okay. So yeah, here we go. So normally you can pay $997. There are payment plans even with this deal. So if you do want to take me up on this, you could just begin with your first payment of $97, and that's 12 monthly payments of $97, but you do save a little bit if you pay in full. I think you get like two, you know what? I wrote here first 5 get VIP upgrade. I'm just doing this so you don't see that. I changed my mind. I told Shannon, I'm like, nope, I'm getting everyone the VIP upgrade until Tuesday at midnight. So the VIP is $1,997 normally, but again, I should have fixed this slide. That is going to be the truth on Tuesday after midnight. So if you're ready to get started, head over to momcoachschool.com. Shannon's on standby. She'll let me know if you want to celebrate in the chat that you took me up on the human design bonus if you sign up now. Otherwise, I think the next slide is, claim your gift. Now, here's the gift. The gift, again, it's self-care for the mom coach. I love this training. I know you're going to love it too. Thanks for joining live, but this training, you're going to love it. So you get instant access to that. It does include worksheets, and I think the video is 35 minutes. I blew my mind. I really love this take. So you're welcome, but thank you to coming on this call. And the last slide, it's simply Q&A time. So I'm going to take a sip of latte. And Shannon, when you have a sec, you can let me know if any questions came through.
Yeah, Yes, there's been a couple of them, and some of them were private, so I just placed them over to everybody. So the first one was, do you have to work with a practice buddy?
No, that is optional. That is totally optional. Yeah, some people opt out of that, but yes, if you want it, it's there for you. So what happens when you get the weekly lessons and week four, you get a little note saying next week you get introduced to your first handful of coaching tools and the coaching framework. Would you like a practice buddy? And it sends you to a form if you do want one. And then I try my best to pair people up with similar time zones, but it's purely optional.
The next one was, what is the time commitment like?
So again, I designed this to be super mama friendly, and I know life stuff comes up. Oh my goodness. Like my son was literally at school for 50% of the school year this year. Like, you know, if he was younger, like that would have taken up like more of my time. So I get it. I get it. What it's like, life stuff comes up. So this is, you know, take at your own pace, work at your own pace. You get lifetime access to it. So it really, it depends where you're at and also kind of what your style is when you take courses or what your goals are, if you have a time frame. So I deliberately created the program again so that you could take in the lessons within 20 minutes to watch the video. Again, the prompts, the assignments is you can go as scant as you want or as deep as you want in your responses, both for handing in some weekly assignments or some prompts to email me back what came up for you, or you can write a full-on essay. I love reading those. So it depends on what you hope to, what your aspirations are. If you're thinking like, you know what, when my, oh my God, you guys, the statistics of the moms who come into this program who have, for some reason, five-year-old sons, it's wacky. I think it's something about like kindergarten. They start kindergarten and then moms are like, ooh, now I can start taking action on this vision, dream, job of mine. So if you have a goal like that, then this is designed to really be a nice pace. Like, okay, try to stick with the schedule here. And then by 3 months' time, you're going to be like really practicing the coaching tools and the framework. And then while you're practicing it a couple of times over, then you can also implement some of the coaching setup, the business setup, the your 4x1, which is my marketing strategy I offer. So it totally depends. But time commitment wise, once a week, 20 minute video, maybe another like half hour to an hour, depending how deep you want to go with the weekly lesson. And then once you get matched up with the practice buddy, you want to budget in an extra once a week call for 4 weeks, and it's 1 hour with your buddy, and you coach her for 30 minutes. And when at the 30 minute mark, you switch spots and then you get coached or vice versa.
Okay. And then two questions that were quite similar. What is the coaching methodology in the program? Mm-hmm. And then how do you teach to get clients?
Okay. The coaching methodology. So it's a hybrid of my creativity coaching background and also just the inspiration of classic coaching tools, but also the simplicity parenting principles, honestly. So I noticed when I became a simplicity parenting coach, it wasn't so much parenting, it was more of a lifestyle. So melding, taking those little baby steps, but also having the awareness of what distractions are pulling me away of how I really want to consciously design my days. So marrying both creativity coaching with the Kaizen Muse approach and holding close to your heart simplicity parenting principles, make up these tools that I share. So the methodology, it very much looks like meeting your client where they're at. So even though you do get introduced to 10 coaching tools, it's not this rigid, like first you must do this. It's like holding space for this mama who just needs a moment protected or to be with just looking at her own sacred needs, to just quieting the clutter in her head, the chit chat, having a quiet moment. And I typically just encourage you to hold some space for her, offer a moment of celebration, and then just getting the conversation start, checking in. How did the little baby bliss step from last week work out? Let's explore what came up for that. And again, sitting on your hands, biting your tongue, and then just full body listening, just a lot of listening, just a very feminine approach, holding space. Invite, would you like to try this coaching tool today? It's like introducing them to a friend. I have this friend over here who can help you with. And so really empowering the mama. So the coaching methodology is very yin in nature. But also just, I'm going to help you acquire the facilitator tools to like in simplicity parenting, you call it the benevolent dictator. It's like firmly, but lovingly holding the boundaries, gently interrupting when need be, but always moving them towards the direction of where they want to be. And usually it's like, they know how to get there. We're just learning how to guide them towards, let's lean on what has worked in the past, and also following what you already know to be true. In other words, your intuition and finding greater access to it.
Wonderful. And then the last one was, is this an ICF certified certification?
You know what? It's not. It's not. And you know what? That other one that we spoke of, like the big one, like the 20,000, that's not either. I'm not going to say what, but it's not either. So so I used to offer this as a certification, and people would ask me, well, is it ICF certified? No, but it's me certified. And now I don't even offer that. What I offer here is an opportunity for you to get comfortable with some coaching tools. So you have confidence. I'm like, yeah, these are proven to work. Again, nothing has, my pen. Nothing new under the sun. Is that the saying? Yeah, this is not reinventing the wheel here. These are all based on classic coaching tools. And also, there's no governing body. Like, you don't have to be certified through ICF in order to offer coaching services by any means. I often say too, the only other people wondering if you're certified through ICF are other coaches. But I like to think of it, it totally depends on your personality. If you feel like that is really important for you, what I offer is an opportunity to try something that, if you're thinking you want to work specifically for moms, for, you know, this is what the intention is, that these are the tools that work beautifully for moms. This is how you hold a coaching session, a series of session. This is how you communicate with like tangible, non fluffy coach speak, you know, what happens when you exchange money for this coaching package. And then if you're feeling, you know what, I do want to, if that's your personality, like, you know, some people, they do get their PhD in, you know, I got my bachelor's degree in communication studies, and I was considering getting my master's, but there's nothing wrong with that. But if you feel compelled, like, yeah, you know, I want to take this deeper, then you can have some time to explore, like, okay, what are some ways, and you could see if this is actually the path for you. But short answer is no, it's not. I see that. Yeah.
All right. That was all the questions so far.
Awesome. Okay. All right. So if you want to take me up on the human design, you have about 2 more seconds here to purchase your spot. If you go for it, I will respond to book that time. And again, you could get the VIP level with the regular pricing investment until Tuesday at midnight. So grab your gifty, enjoy. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'm just curious what time it is. Ooh, 15 minutes over. So thank you for sticking around a little later. And I hope you have a joyous rest of your day. Bye, everyone.